Yeah, this is a joint work with Emilio Baruchov, Politecnico Milano, and Editor Oci from Milano Bicocca. And the idea is to investigate with some easy mathematical tools about the volatility adjustment, what is required by the EIOPA regulation, so basically two frameworks, and also to understand how the new proposal for a volatility adjustment will impact for insurance companies. So we are under the Solvency II framework, where the key point is to have a consistent evaluation of assets and liabilities. Mainly, we are on the side of the liability, given that the volatility adjustment is something which has to be used in order to discount liabilities in order to cover what is asked from the directive, in order to prevent pro-cyclical investment behavior. So what they want is to make a correction to the risk-free interest rate structure in order to mitigate any possible exaggeration connected to the bond spread. Therefore, the idea is that the risk-free rate curve is used, but I mean, we have a discount curve, and we want to adjust this discount curve with this volatility adjustment, which is just a constant to be added to the discount factor, in order to take into account the component of the spread of bonds not associated with fundamentals, and so not really connected to credit quality of bonds. There is a lot of discussion on the volatility adjustment. There was and there is, because I mean, the volatility adjustment was introduced few years ago. Then in 2019, there was a question from EIOPA asking to think about how to change the volatility adjustment. In 2020, we have a proposal, and now we are still discussing. I mean, they're still discussing how to deal with this proposal. There are a lot of problems that are discussed because, I mean, the problems are both on two things. One thing is the impact of volatility adjustment, and the other impact thing is that if that instrument is able to do what the regulator wants. So problems are, for example, connected to the fact that the current VIA, the in-force VIA, does not take into account the liquidity of liabilities. There can be cliff effect for the country-specific component, as I will show you, and some misestimation of risk correction. All these things are in, some of these things are considered in the proposal, but we have to understand, we want to understand with this work if the proposal solves all the problem or if we are far from having a good construction of the volatility adjustment. Now, so this is our motivation. And this is what we did. So we reconstruct the volatility adjustment on different countries on the monthly basis. We construct the in-force one, and we also construct the proposal in order to analyze if both volatility adjustment, or at least one of the two, works well. For example, what is good is that both VA are not affected by credit quality, which is good because means that given that VA must capture the part of the curve which is not connected to the credit quality of the bond, it's good that there is no connection between that, as well as the liquidity of the bond. However, we also try to compute what is the impact of the proposed VA with respect to the existing one. For example, we can think about it that for most of the countries, we show that the new mechanism is gives higher values and therefore gives advantages for insurance companies. So basically, under this aim, this is the sketch of today's presentation. So I will introduce you what is the volatility adjustment from a mathematical point of view, how we can compute it, considering both the in-force and the proposal. Mainly is based on computational of internal rate of return of given portfolios. Then we start with the descriptive analysis to show what happened to the volatility adjustment in the past, also during the financial crisis, and the Euro crisis, most of all. And we also present the results, assuming that the VIA proposed was in force at that time. So to make a comparison of both the volatility adjustment. Then we did a time series analysis in order to deal with multi regressions, in order to study the connection of the VA with respect to, for example, CDS, in order to compute in a mathematical way if there is any connection between the credit quality, for example, and the volatility adjustment. And as I told you before, for in this case, the answer is no. We consider several indexes in order to compare what the volatility adjustment against this in a regression style, in order to get some information about the evolution of the VA with both in force and proposal with respect to the indexes that we consider. And then with a simple Monte Carlo simulation, we try to study the impact that both VA will have for insurance companies that can use the VA in order to discount the liabilities. Now, let's start describing what is the volatility adjustment, which is nothing else that I told you that a number that should be added to the discount factor when an insurance company discount liabilities. The VA is composed, or better, the in-force VA, the one that will be changed in the future probably, consists of two components. One component is the currency component. So for example, for Italy is the component connected to the euro, for UK is the component connected to the British pound, and the country component. Let's start with the currency. The currency is defined as 75%, a number which is the risk-corrected currency spread, which is defined as the difference between the currency spread, which is the spread on government and corporate bonds included in the reference portfolio for that currency, and the risk correction. And so the key point is to compute spread risk correction, obtain the risk corrected spread, and then get the volatility adjustment. The country component is similar because we have again 75% times a number which is given by the difference between the risk corrected country spread, which is again country spread minus risk correction, minus 2 times the risk corrected currency spread. And once we compute these two components, we have that the current VA, the in-force one, is what we have in equation 4, but I mean, can be easily written as the fact that the current VA is the VA currency if the risk-corrected spread for the country is smaller than 1%. Otherwise, it is the summation of the currency VA and the country VA. So we have a trigger event, a trigger level, which is this 1%. If it is above 1%, the VA contains also the country component. Otherwise, this is no more true. In 2019, the European Parliament approved a change of the threshold, moving from 1% to 0.85%. Our analysis showed that this change, this modification of the threshold, would have no impact in the past. Because, I mean, any time that it happens that the 1% threshold is was passed, obviously also the 0.85 threshold was passed, but there is no time in which there was a threshold for a country between 0.85 and 1%. So basically, analyzing the past, we can say that this has no effect on the computation of the VA. So with this in mind, we have that the VA is equal to the VA currency, or the VA is equal to the summation between the currency and the country component, depending on a threshold, which is 1%, which was 1%, and nowadays 0.85%. And we can understand that everything relies on the computation of this risk-corrected spread. Now, this risk-corrected spread is nothing else the difference between spread and the risk correction. And the risk correction is the portion of the spread that is connected to a realistic assessment of expected loss. How to compute it? The idea is to compute the spread for government bond for each currency, the spread for other than government bond for each currency, and then multiply by some weights which are given by EIOPA. The same for the risk correction. So we have EIOPA provide us weights and then provide us information about the construction of this spread and the risk correction. What does it mean, information? Information, because each of these spreads, so the government part spread for a currency, the government part spread for a country, the corporate spread, as well as the older risk correction, are always computed as differences of internal rate of returns. And basically, we have three internal rate of return, because EIOPA provides for each country and for each currency, a called representative portfolio of bonds, government bonds, but also corporate bonds. And then for each country, what we have to do is to follow the procedure, which is more or less like this. I say more or less because I'm going to depict the one for government part. It's changed a little bit if you have to deal with the corporate part, because you have also to consider loss given default and probability of default. Now, the idea is that we construct a market interest rate curve for each bond issuer. We construct the market interest rate curve according to the EIOPA documentation, starting from EIOPA, from what declares a bond to be used by EIOPA, till 2020 was Bloomberg. From 2020, EIOPA move on Refinitiv as a data provider. So we construct the market interest rate curve for that bond issuer, but in the government cases, that means for that country. Then EIOPA give us also a risk pre-constructed risk-free curve. And for each bond issuer, we have a duration. And therefore we interpolate both the market interest rate curve, which come from the market data, and the risk-free curve, which might come from EIOPA, in the corresponding duration. And then we compute the risk correction, which for government component is 30% of the long-term average spread, which is again provided by EIOPA. If we are in the euro area, otherwise it's 35% the LTAS. and subtracting the risk correction to the market interest rate curve, we have another curve, the risk-corrected curve. And so we can interpolate this curve in the corresponding duration. Therefore, given a currency or a country, we have for each bond issuer that belongs to the reference portfolio of this currency or country, a, at the end, a zero coupon bond, which price is given exactly by the value that we compute on the curve. But therefore, we have three possible values for this zero coupon bond: a market value, a risk-free value, and the risk-corrected value. Then, given that we have not only one issuer, but several issuers, we have a portfolio of issuers, therefore we have a portfolio of zero coupon bond, at the end, we have a cash flow. Basically, we have three cash flows: a cash flow is according to the market curve, about the risk-free, and about the risk-corrected. And therefore, we can compute three interest rate returns: one exploiting the market curve, the second, the basic risk-free curve, the third with the market curve risk-corrected. And with these three, we can compute each of these components. This is the mechanism that is behind the in-force VA. What about the proposal? The proposal is quite similar with some changes. The first of all, the first change is that the VA proposal is always equal to the summation between the permanent component, which is what was the currency VA, and the macro component, which corresponds to what was the country VA. So we do not have any more a trigger effect. We do not need someone that the risk-corrected spread is larger than 1% to have also the country component. VA is always equal to the summation of these two components. The permanent component is equal to 85%, the general application ratio, which now is increased because it was at 65%. And then we have a multiplication of two application ratio. Because in the past, one of the problem of the current in-force VA is that there was no connection with illiquidity and with the mismatch of asset and liabilities, duration mismatch. And therefore, in the new mechanism, EIOPA introduced the multiplication of two terms which are company-specific and depends on duration mismatch and illiquidity of liability. And then we have RC/FCU, which is nothing else but the risk-corrected spread, is exactly the SRC of the old EIOPA, just a change in notation, times a scale CU, which is a scale which is 1 over the summation of the weights. Because in the old EIOPA version, this omega does not sum 1. So for some country, it sum 0.8, for some other, it sum 1.2, and so on. In order to correct this fact, there was an introduction of this component. The country component, again, is more or less similar. We have 85% times these two component times omega. Then, if you remember, the country VA was the risk correction minus 2 times the currency risk correction. Now we have, again, the risk-corrected spread for the country, but multiply by this in order to take into account the fact that the weights does not sum 1, minus no more 2, but 1.3 in order to have a increase, I mean, in order to have something larger than the previous case, so to increase the probability that this maximum is positive, times the risk-corrected spread, again corrected by the fact that the weights are not, does not sum to one. Then in the old VA, we can see that this, which is the country VA, is multiplied by a trigger event, something which is zero and then becomes one. This is not anymore present, but now we have this omega, which is something that is zero, then linearly increase, and then remains to one. So we have no more the jump 0-1, but we have something smooth in order to activate the application, to activate the mechanism, the country component. So a linear smooth application of the country component. So this is how the enforced and proposal VA works. And so what we did is to reconstruct the VA of 18 countries, working with the 12 countries of the euro area and other six non-euro country with 61 monthly observation from November 2015 to November 2020. A first analysis is to study when it happens that the country component really enter into the definition of the VA. So when we have that the VA is no more, the incurrent VA is not more equal to the currency VA, and for the proposed one, where the proposed VA is not equal to the permanent. So basically, when this term is different from zero, and when this term, the one that we have here, is different from zero. And we can see that, I mean, this is happens few time for the current VA. The current VA enter into the definition of, the current VA was affected by the country component only 11 time in these 5 years, 8 times from Greece and 3 times from Italy, which in the period in which there was the crisis for the the euro crisis and the problem of this possible default of Greece, and also Italy was not in a good situation. For all the other case, maybe it happens that the country VA was greater than zero, but the risk-corrected spread was smaller than 0.85%. And so even if we have a country component which is not zero, it has no effect on the VA. If we look at the macro, so the proposed VA, we have that the macro, so the country component is positive, obviously a number of times larger than, so, I mean, while the current VA was affected by the country component only 11 times, if we compute the macro VA and we apply the proposed VA to this 5 year, we see that from 11, we arrive to more or less 60 times where the country component entered into the this definition. However, again, this happened for Greece, Italy, Portugal, and Spain. So for country with a financial problem, with some debt problem, and therefore the insurance company in that country can exploit the VA in order to have a better discount of the liabilities. This is how the current VA, which is in blue, and the proposal VA looks like. And we can see that more or less it is larger than the new one is larger than the current, which means that there is a improvement for insurance company. I mean, the exception are Czech Republic, Spain, UK, and Poland, for which the value are very close. For other case, it is obviously better. I mean, look here, Portugal, for in the path for an insurance company in Portugal between 2016 and 2017. With the new VA, we have a larger impact, larger VA, and so an improvement in the discount of the liabilities. We also have that, for example, looking at Italy, the fact that we substitute the trigger event, the 1%, with a smooth activation function, the Omega that I show you, give that it is not possible to see something like this, where there is an activation, then the month after there is no, you are under the activation, and so it's go down, and then the month after, again, it's activated to jump up. So we do not have many more this cliff effect according to the proposed VA.
Daniel, if I interrupt, what yes. was this event in between 2018 and 19? If you go back one slide.
I mean, it's not an event. I mean, it was a period in which there was a large problem of debt for Italy and for the banks in Italy. And maybe on 1 month, the risk corrected spread is 1.02, the other one is 0.99, and then goes to 1.01. So this small change means that if you go from 1.00 to 1.09, so to 0.99, there is no more activation.
While, of course, the spike that is present on the rightmost part around March 2020 in all countries is due to the COVID,
yes, the beginning exactly.
of the pandemic. And it's remarkable that, for instance, in Italy, it's smaller than in Slovakia. But anyway, yeah. it's present everywhere.
Yes, yes. this Portugal, is quite consistent. I mean, more maybe Bulgaria is the one with the smallest spike, but also Greece, probably. But I mean, for all the other countries, we have this spike,
mm-hmm. yes,
which is done like this, because we are using bond, Quindi, and so now. Here I'm going to show you the mean and variance of the VA proposed and current for all the countries. And we can see that expected for the proposed VA, the mean value is larger. We can also see that basically also the variance of the mean, the new proposed VA is larger. And therefore, even if with some exceptions, for example, Austria, Belgium, and so on, has a variance which is smaller. But when we reach other countries like Greece or Italy, where we have a larger values of VA, then in this case, we have an increase in the variance, probably also due to the fact that we have no more the cliff effect and the VA macro component enter into the definition of the price of the VA, sorry, a lot of times. Then I would like to also to show another things. If you look at the mean value for Austria, Belgium, Germany, Spain, Finland, France, and so on are always the same. Why? Because for this country, the country component does not enter into the definition of the VA. And so the VA is only defined by the currency component, which is the euro company. And therefore, it's always the same. While in the proposed VA, things change because it's true that we have a currency component, but the currency component is always the euro. But okay, this value has to be multiplied by the application ratio 4 and 5, which are country specific, basically, which are company specific. Now, let's move on the time series analysis. Okay, after a description of the mechanism, and an historical analysis of how this VA looks like, it's time to try to get some information about the connection between the VA, which is our Y, and other factors, which are the X, Z, and so on. So we have a regression with an autoregressive component. And then we have several factors, and we compute different factors. For example, we consider equity index and volatility of the equity index. We consider the yield at 10 year, as well as the steepest of the curve, which is the difference between the 10 year and the 1 year yield. Then we consider also credit default swap in order to study the connection between the credit part of the market and the VA, and the beta spread as a measure of illiquidity, as well as economic sentiment. And then a global factor like the VIX, the spread between BAA and AAA rated bonds in the US market, the Euro Stoxx volatility, and the iBox volatility. And here it's a table with results for different specification for the current VA and for the proposed VA. I would like to tell you that we try to perform all the possible combination, and if they do not appear in this table, it is because the model has no statistical meaning. Without entering too much the detail, what are the main point of view that we have to take from this table? First of all, let's look at CDS. CDS in this case appear only on column 7 that we take here as just as an example, and the Arellano bond is 0.01. Therefore, we have a coefficient which is smaller than 0.1, and therefore means that this model is not statistically meaningful. There is no model with CDS, 5-year CDS, statistically meaningful between the considering VA proposal and VA currency, which is good, which is in agreement with the regulation, because VA should not reflect the credit quality of assets. Then, about the illiquidity, we take beta spread as a measure of illiquidity. And we can see that the beta spread is almost negative for the current VA, with one case in which there is no significance, but the other case are okay. So we have high significance, statistical significance. For the proposed VA, it is never statistically significant. And what we expect? We should observe a positive statistically significant coefficient for this variable, but we have a negative connection for the current VA, not significant for the VA proposed. We can say from this analysis that the proposed VA is better because go towards what the regulation wants, improving the current VA, but also the proposed VA is not able to capture the connection with liquidity, with illiquidity. Then for the country specific, we'll work with equity market return and volatility of the equity market. There are always statistical significance with only one exception. And we have a positive coefficient for volatility, negative for equity market, for both the current VA and the proposed VA. However, here it's not so easy to say something about the regulation, about the fact that the VA over or under react to the performance of the economy. And for global indexes, we see that there is no significant connection between risk aversion and VA, and while there is a connection with VIX. Even if VIX is global turbulence indicator, probably a European turbulence indicator was better, because this is not connected to the economic fundamentals of European countries. And same if we look at the bond, because we have sensitivity to the 10-year bond for the proposed VA and to the steepness of the curve for the, again, proposed VA, while if we look at the current VA, there is no sensitivity. And therefore, we can say that the proposed VA go towards a sensitivity with respect to the yield rate of the bond. So with this in mind, we can say that under this analysis, the proposed VA is an improvement of the current VA, even if not all the things are supportive of what the regulator asked for. Now, let's consider the point of view of of an insurance company, which has to face liability. We want to analyze with the Monte Carlo simulation the situation of this insurance company in 2 years, after 1 year, and after 5 years. We start at the end of December 2020, for a company which face liability having a bell shape with discounted value equal to 100 million euros. This is the shape of our liability, for example, for France. And here are the duration of the liabilities, which are given by EIOPA, obviously not for a company, but for a country. We assume that the company has the same duration of the country. Same, we have a portfolio of assets, which has 100 million value at time zero. So we have a perfect match between duration and assets value at time zero, discounted duration, and the duration of the asset is exactly equal to the duration of the country-specific portfolio, and is given here in this table. And then we model the risk country component, the risk-corrected spread for the country, the risk-corrected spread for the currency, and all the bonds and the risk-free curve exploiting correlated Vasicek model, which is this model, a mean reverting model, where mu is the mean reversion, lambda is the speed of the reversion. And we calibrate with a maximum likelihood procedure the risk corrected spread. We exploit bond formulas for the Vasicek to calibrate bond spot rates as well as the risk free curve. And we compute historical correlation between this quantity number 12 correlated winner profit. So for each country, we deal with a company of that country with the asset of the reference portfolio of the country and 100 million discounted value of liability, having the duration equal to the duration of the liability for that country, given by EIOPA. And we make a simulation of what happened after 1 year and what happened after 5 years. And then we compute the expected value and the variance of the difference between assets and discounted values. And here are the results of expected value. Obviously, the current VA is always a improvement of discounted without VA, with only one exception, which is Bulgaria. Because for Bulgaria, we can see from that picture, is the only case in which the current VA becomes negative. And therefore, it's no more using the VA, exploiting the VA is no more an advantage for the company. In all other cases, it is an advantage. But what is important for us is more to deal with the benefits of using the proposed VA with respect to the current VA. So when the second column is smaller than the third one. And we can see again that we have advantages in exploiting the proposed VA. So the proposed VA is an advantage for all the country with the exception of UK, where the values are very similar, Czech Republic, Spain, and Poland. So for four countries, the new proposed VA is not an improvement. Values are more or less the same. For Czech Republic is the one with the worst impact on moving the new proposal because we have lower values, while for the other 14 countries, there is a large improvement in exploiting the new proposed VA. Therefore, the new proposed VA can become as an improvement, more than improvement, an advantage for insurance company. We also investigate about the probabilities that the country component would enter into the definition of the VA. And again, we have that this is larger for the proposed VA in line with the table that I show you here, the first table that I show you. For the proposed VA, there is a larger probability to have a VA which contains the country component, which is the macro in the proposal because it's 11 against this from an historical point of view. If we deal with Monte Carlo simulation, we obtain the same. I mean, the percentage is higher, but again, it's non-negligible only for Greece, Portugal, Italy, and Spain. And as a last exercise that we did, then I finish, given that we have the VA benefit, so value of asset liability with exploiting the VA minus the value without the VA, so this is the benefit in using the VA, but we also have duration mismatch, because here there is a duration mismatch between liability and assets. And therefore, we make this plot for the in-force VA and the proposal VA. Because one of the things that the regulator wants to avoid is that there are some cases in which countries have a larger advantage to exploit the VA against the other. And this is due, for example, to some advantages in duration mismatch. Country with a larger duration mismatch, company with a larger duration mismatch has an advantage in order to exploit the VA. So what we do is to make this picture and to compute a linear regression, and we have that the coefficient of the linear regression is positive, which go towards the direction that there is larger benefit if you have a larger duration mismatch. However, the R square of the regression is very low. It is also true that we are making a regression with 18 observations, so there are limits on this exercise. The p-value of the coefficient is 0.07 and 0.10 for the current and proposed, so it is neither highly significant. So we can say that there is a very, really, really weak, very weak information about and a limited evidence that there is a positive relationship. So the problem to have a VA mechanism which give an overshooting effect in case of large duration mismatch is really with limited evidence. So concluding, what I show you today is an exercise where, starting from a regulator point of view and starting from the documentation of the current VA and the proposed VA, we use simple mathematical tools like multiple regression as well as Monte Carlo simulation in order to analyze if the current VA and, more important, the proposed VA can act in this in the direction that the regulator wants. Because, I mean, in this case, there is only the point of view if the model is done is consistent from a financial point and for us mathematical point of view, or it's more something that comes from a politics discussion. So there are some point in which we can see that the proposed VA is a improvement with respect to current VA. However, there are some open problems. For example, we expect a positive that the VA is positively affected by the liquidity, but it is not true. It's negative affected by liquidity of bond for the current, and there is no significant coefficient, so it's not affected by the proposed one. And however, I mean, just concluding, we can say that the proposed VA is an improvement, an advantage more than improvement for insurance company, given that it is larger, its impact is larger for 15 countries over 18. And for this, I conclude. If there is any curiosity or question, please ask me.